Scott, what happened to you?
Well, Mike, you talked about Mike, though, right? Mike had a photo, too. When did Mike's happen?
How long ago?
Well, Mike's on the phone. What happened to me was I was doing yard work, and I got this old pair of ratty shorts that I wear. And I split my pants straight up the ass crack. Split them. But
like, how big of a split? Like, we're talking all of it.
Oh, hello there.
Okay.
But I was kind of done doing yard work, so it wasn't a big deal. I just kind of went in the house, and whatever got changed. And then the next week, I went back out to do yard work. I had totally forgotten that I had split my pants. Put the same shorts back on.
Oh, no.
Not realizing it. Did all of my yard work with my ass out, and I didn't even notice it until the end.
And if you're new to the program, hi.
I don't wear underwear.
Scott doesn't wear underwear. Yes, so your full-blown ass is
just out.
And you're bending over to pick up rocks and
I didn't feel it. I don't know how I didn't feel it or recognize it, but yeah, my shorts, I put on a pair of split shorts and did in my entire yard.
You didn't feel any wind on the rocks of Gibraltar?
I didn't. I don't know how that was possible.
Oh, man. Dante's Peak didn't catch any of that breeze. That's funny, because I feel like if I've split... And I've split it good. I'm definitely feeling something. And you were there the entire time.
I think it was warm enough out that it might have been hot. I think it was hot out.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't feel any cool breeze. Normally, it's the cool breeze that lets you know.
Cool breeze. Oh, yeah. You get that nice, hot, drenchy sweat. And you did the whole lawn. Didn't even realize until you were done.
Mm-hmm. With my ass out.
Hilarious. So we ask you, 410-338-1098. When's the last time you fully blew the... This is a crack right out of your ass on the when you split the seam. Who did this happen to on late night television? Recently, this happened to Nick Kroll. That's who it was. Yeah, look up Nick Kroll from the Kroll Show.
Yeah,
and I think he just split his pants. Split his pants on Kimmel, and I think Kimmel helped him like tape his pants back up. I think it was like a week ago. Yeah, split him in the back. I was like, screw it. Not going to miss out on this promotional opportunity to go out there and hawk whatever, and then fully points his ass to the camera, and there it is. On top of that, he had a real nice sweat splotch on the underwear. Yeah, so not terribly hot. All right, so let's go to the phones real quick. Who's been holding? We'll go to Mike in Baltimore. Hey, Mikey, how you doing, bud?
Good morning, I'm good.
All right, so when'd you split your pants? Where were you?
Oh, my. So I was working down in D.C. I'm a heavy equipment operator. And I was getting up in the excavator. And when I went to step up, I split it right up the middle. I mean, not the backside, but the front side. I split it completely up. And it couldn't have been a worse day because the boxers that I had on were already pre-ripped. Oh. So it was all hanging out.
You got pre-ripped boxers.
Oh, you got filthy, dirty old boxers. And you split it clean up the front.
Clean up. I mean, it couldn't have happened on a worse day. I was loading trucks. It was in D.C., busy road. People were walking by, and here I am. I got my legs kind of spread because of the foot pedals, and yeah, it was all on.
What do? You make a little duct tape diaper or something, or?
No, I just had to rock with it. I just had to keep adjusting my boxers, so you know, it was all tucked away.
Keep the Baldwins from coming to dinner.
Yeah, I didn't need my bald-headed yoga slinger hanging out.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
hello there.
My guy. Let's talk to Daryl in Columbia. Daryl in Columbia. Good morning, bud. Daryl. All right, Daryl ain't there. We'll go to line... here's Daryl. Daryl's on line 4. Daryl.
Hello.
Hey, Daryl.
Daryl.
Morning.
Morning.
What up?
Hey.
Morning.
When'd you split them?
So, well, first of all, I'll explain, I was overtired, working like 5 jobs at the same time, and I had to get out real fast and make it to school. I didn't know when I snagged my back pocket on my front door handle that I'd split them all the way down the middle and the back.
Yeah.
I got all the way to school, went to the university center to make a phone call. Thought that there was some kind of a breeze, but didn't think about it because I was too busy.
Yeah.
Pack of co-eds who was sitting behind me finally decides to come over and let me know that, the new moon was out.
Oh,
yeah.
Poor fella. God, you got a bunch of
it's
beautiful
worse
girls.
Than co-eds. Yeah.
Excuse me, mister. I can see your old balls. So if you want to just get that handled. Oh, that's funny. Let's talk to Cody in Baltimore, the leader of the Bullet Club. Cody, what's up?
Good morning.
Hey.
So I was back in high school trying to present a pretty good chunk of my my 12th grade English class grade on this presentation. So I'm in the middle of the presentation, and I drop the remote for the projector. So I turn around to pick it up, and my pants split from the seam of my belt loop all the way down to my knee in front of a whole class full of guys.
Yeah.
The whole class went nuts.
Just started cheering. Like,
they lost their minds.
What did you have on beneath it?
Oh, I had a little pair of tighty whiteys on because I didn't have any laundry.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. You got
it,
that
it was pretty embarrassing.
How'd you do on the presentation? What'd you get?
Oh, I got an A.
Yeah,
got an extra credit on that one too.
You got an A because you saw your B's. Good job, buddy. Let's go to Alex in Germantown. Alex, when did you split your pants?
Oh, I was out in the woods walking with my girlfriend on the trail, and there was a fallen tree on the path, and I, you know, was trying to be cool and hop over it. But it was a little muddy out, so I slipped as I was trying to jump and split my pants in half.
Yeah. I'm imagining these stories and I'm laughing.
Are so great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did she say? What did she just laugh?
Oh, she had one heck of a laugh.
Oh, that's so funny. I want to talk to a woman that has split her pants.
Oh, I got it. Well, I got a text here that.
Thank you, bud.
Female softball player. My college teammate went commando under her softball uniform. Ooh. She was covering second on a steal. The girl that slid into second cleats up, split my teammate's pants from the inseam all the way. Inseam of her thigh all the way to her lady region. Total exposure.
Oh, I got another one from Amanda. I once split my pants when I squatted down to pick something up. Instead of splitting up the middle, it split underneath between both of my butt cheeks. Hashtag big ass problems. Ain't nothing wrong with a big ass. And then I got one more here on the tweets. Patrick says, I blew out my crotch of my suit at a funeral. As luck would have it, I had gone commando as I do most days. And there was thankfully, I was getting back in the car when leaving McDonald's and the ass of my jeans ripped open on my wallet side. Okay, so Patrick, you just need to start wearing tights from now on. You're not good with pants. Wow, this is a weird place to be. Chris Odenton, where were you?
I was in Afghanistan.
Oh, okay.
It didn't actually happen to me. It happened to one of my soldiers. This is when you were trying to first get females into these Shura meetings. And he always went commando. And when we were in these meetings, you would always kind of squat. He did a squat and his pants ripped and his hulk all came out.
Hold on. Just here. All his stuff came out. Sorry. I'm sorry. So he squats. He's trying to have a productive meeting with the locals, and then all the inventory spills out onto the floor.
Yeah, the Afghani females all just kind of went like this, and they all kind of turned. I'm going like this. I'm thinking to myself, going, oh man, this is our first meeting like this, and I'm going, this is gonna like completely break rapport. But sure enough, the Afghani males, after getting all the females out, we all kind of joked and laughed about it. And afterwards, it came a running joke for that soldier for about 3 years.
Oh, well, thank you for your service. Thank you for his rifle.